High Commissioner, this must be a very, very proud day today for you.
It is a proud day for me. It's a day which causes me to reflect, probably even more, a day of reflection and proud and pride mixed in. Yes.
Those young men 65 years ago, what do you think was going through their heads when they took the decision to come to the UK?
Well, you know, some of them had already been here. Many of them had fought in the war, in the RAF. And so after the war, I think they came back to England looking for a better life for themselves. I heard of the original interview. A young man said he was single and he had come here to look for a better life, to help his mom, to help his mother. So I think that they came with expectation that they were coming here. They knew they were coming here to help to rebuild Britain after the war. And so they were expectant that they were going to get work and that they were going to have a better life for themselves here.
Which was life in Jamaica that poor standard in those days?
Jamaica was like every other country. We were not even independent yet. We were still a colony of Britain, and so whatever was happening in Jamaica was the responsibility of Britain, because they controlled what happened in the country at the time. And yes, the most of the people would have been poor. They would have been poor farmers, a lot of the people who came on the Windrush and even on the other ships that came over the next decade or so, came from rural Jamaica looking for opportunities that they thought would exist in a big metropolitan country like the UK. And that's the same reason that people come to the UK from all over the world even now.
That,
you know?
That was my next question. It's 65 years later in Jamaica, is it still an attraction to come to the UK?
It is, but you don't have as many people coming here anymore because the immigration rules have changed, and Britain has probably opened up to other countries and close the doors on the West Indies, and certainly on Jamaica. You don't have immigration from Jamaica being as open as it was in the earlier days. But there is still immigration from all over the world. There are people coming here to the UK even now from other countries because they're looking for the same thing that those people were looking for in 1965, which is a better way of life for them and their family.
You've had a brief look around the exhibition this morning. What do you think of it?
I think that this is a very good attempt at preserving what took place 65 years ago. I saw a newsreel, which they tell me it's the only one piece that exists of interviews with persons who were coming off the ship. And I heard Lord Kitchener and that song he wrote about London is the place for me. And you know, Lord Kitchener went on to become one of the greatest calypsonians of his time. I grew up hearing about Lord Kitchener. What I didn't know is that he had come on the Windrush to London. I just discovered that today. But I mean, he's written some really fabulous songs that I grew up with. And I've seen photographs and I've seen commentaries, the newspaper reports and so on. I think this is a really excellent attempt at preserving the history of the time and helping to remind our people, and I say this all the time, those who came, I can speak about the Jamaicans, they came because there was an advertisement put in the newspapers inviting them to come to the UK, you know. They came on the invitation of the British to come here and help to reconstruct Britain after the war, and they did.
They're a major part in the history of London transport as well.
They're a major part of London transport. They're a major part of British telecoms. They're a major part of the NHS. The nurses downstairs, there is also a part of the exhibition is the recognition of the nurses who came in that period. they're a major part of all of the construction and development that took place in the UK from the 1940s up to now, and they're still playing their part here.
And the Windrush landings is now an integral part of British history.
It is. And I was very pleased to see that in the opening of the Olympics last year, that recognition was given. There's been some discussion about whether it was enough, but for me, the fact that it was recognized was a good thing.
Hi, Commissioner, thank you very much. Can I buy your number plate? I love your number plate.
It's not for sale. And we have had many offers. Thank you.